Bonjour, mon nom est Charlotte Christ. This is EuroBasket Woman Day 10.
And a big day in Lille. The last two vacancies left to be filled in the quarterfinals. And one of them decided in the opening game. Italy, knowing a win over Montenegro would be enough to send them through. But their opponents fighting to stay alive in the competition as well. Here's an early three from Jelena Skerovic. Italy soon making a run back to Raffaella Masciardi from deep. Team high 15 points for her, their lead at 6 after 7 minutes. Montenegro next to make an impact, Skerovic finding some room. An 11-0 run from Montenegro putting them up by 9 in the second period. Italy down by 9 at half time, their fate very much in the balance and in need of a comeback. And they got one. 9 straight points in the third, bringing them level. Francesca Dotto converting off the steal. Jelena Dubljevic, excellent throughout this tournament. A game high 20 points for her. Roberto Cricchini urging his team to make one more vital push. Survival, the name of the game. And it was Italy who stay alive. A late 13-4 run taking them into the next round, celebrating a 66-6 victory.
I mean, it's incredible. I can't believe right now what we did. We start good, but then we had our difficulties like pretty much every second quarter. But we, in the half court, in the locker room, we had the power to come back stronger, because we were not playing some good defense. Dubljevic and Skerovic were scoring from everywhere. We didn't push them. So I told the girls to be aggressive, also to make 5 fouls, but to be aggressive, because it's our strength and it's what we did, and we won.
Montenegro not quite out, but they had to watch and hope as Sweden took on Slovakia. A win for the Swedes, enough to extend their stay. The Slovaks hoping to block their path, but with a small chance themselves to progress. The Swedes seizing control in the first quarter, a 13-0 burst, actually key. Team up by as much as 16 in the second. The Slovaks still fighting. Lucia Kupryshkova, team best 15 points. Her side down by 46-36 at half time. Sweden trying to pull away. Katarina Andersson with the putback. Slovakia applying some pressure, swatted away by Anna Bartelt. But the gap cut in the third, game on once again. Lars Johansson looking for a reaction, and he got one. Lead back up to 9 with 5 to play. Frida Eldebrink and Elizabeth Engel with 17 point cheats. Sweden holding on for a 75-72 win. They move on to the quarterfinals.
I'm so proud of the whole team. We did a really good job on fighting today, and we knew it was going to be tough. We're going to enjoy this moment right now, and then tomorrow morning we're going to start concentrate and focus on France.
Montenegro and Slovakia both out of the competition. The Slovaks not with enough to progress.
Because the level here, it's higher than our competition in Slovakia, or because our players are mostly from Slovakia league. This tournament, it's more physically. It's about it be more hard, and we was not enough aggressive, and we didn't play our fast break. It's about this.
Last game of the second round, first place in Group E on the line, and Spain and Turkey hoping to make some noise, knowing only one team will move on with their unbeaten record in safe hands. The lead swinging to and fro early, Bahar Sigler from up top for the Turks. And what do you know, she likes that spot so much, but here she goes again. Sancho Little heading Spanish hopes, giving them an early lead. She ended with 18 points and 13 rebounds. But the centre also a huge defensive presence. Her side pulling away in the second quarter. A huge 15-0 run, taking them as much as 16 ahead. Turkey trying to find a response. There's Isel Albin finding a way through. But Turkey's biggest impact from Cornita Hollingsworth, taking it into the paint. Spain finding themselves in a fight, the gap down to just 4 late in the third period. Lucas Mondello working out a plan B, but his team coming good. A 15-4 run in the final stages, taking them to a 61-48 victory over Turkey, and a real statement of intent as they move on into the latter stages.
They give you confidence anytime you win a game, especially Turkey, which was unbeaten, and we were unbeaten.
But as I could say, we had heart. They came back, but we opened it back out, and I gotta congratulate the team.
Turkey, not the result or the performance that they would have wanted.
It was such a good wake-up call for us, actually. I am almost gonna say I am glad we lost against Spain, because we know that we cannot go for medal if we keep playing like this. First quarter, second quarter, we play real slow, not up tempo. But second half, we go out there, we were very tough, and for a while it was 5 points. It went back to 5 points. So we have to keep that game on all the time if we want something on the first five.
So there's the final standings in Group E. Spain beating Turkey into first place, one of only two teams with a perfect 6 wins out of 6 so far in France. Italy in third, Sweden fourth, Montenegro and Slovakia though bidding farewell to the tournament. And confirmation there of the quarterfinals, they take place at the Pavel Arena in Orsi. Wednesday's two games seeing the Czech Republic meeting Spain and Serbia taking on Italy. And then on Thursday, we'll start with Belarus against Turkey, and then the host France meeting Sweden. It's win or go home time at EuroBasket Women. Follow it all at FIBAEurope.com.